Daiso is one of the world's leading purveyors of cheap crap that breaks within a couple hours of you using it. Although that's pretty harsh, it is a very useful store. Think of it as like a Japanese Dollarama. And on my recent trip to South Korea, I was real excited to see a big Daiso, because I just had to go look to see what kind of electronics they had. And they did not disappoint, with a whole bunch of gaming branded PC peripherals, none of which cost more than like $3.50. So today, let's see what $2 slipper candy shop electronics are like. Now, all of these products, aside from this little thing, cost 5,000 won, which translates to about $3.50. And that includes speakers, headphones, we've got a webcam. Yeah, I don't think I can call this a gaming mouse, but a mouse, a definitely gaming keyboard, because it's all RGB and stuff, and a gaming mouse pad. In total, all of this stuff together cost like $25 for an entire gaming setup worth of peripherals. Ooh, there's even a little glory hole on the mouse pad so that you can get a nice feeling for its texture. It doesn't feel too terrible. Let's start off with this. Now, in terms of accessories, it comes with this micro USB cable. It's a bit disappointing that it's not USB-C, but it did cost $3, so what can you really ask from it? Okay, I take it back. It's not a great feeling mouse pad, but again, it does light up. You can see it's got this light pipe that runs all around, and then it is RGB. You can even change modes on it, I think, by using that selector button. Now, unfortunately, it's not a very big mouse pad, so if you're one of those low sensitivity flick gamers, this isn't really gonna work for you. But I've seen smaller, worse size mouse pads, so it could have been worse. Now, going by the box, this mouse is tiny. Now, according to the box, the only bit of English on it says that it's wireless. So that's good. It means we're gonna have some nice latency while gaming. Very exciting. Oh, that's like chalkboard nails sound. Wow, that is about as ergonomically terrible as an Apple mouse. Although, maybe a little bit better. So it's got that going for it. Let's see, did it come with a battery? It doesn't! What an outrage! Although it does cost about as much as a battery, so I guess it makes sense. I cannot wait to see these speakers. For $3.50, you get stereo and it's RGB. So these are already a slam dunk. Considering that there's USB and aux, I'm assuming USB is for power. You also have an inline volume wheel, something I've never seen on speakers before. Why not just put the potentiometer on the bit on your desk? Because if you have this set up, the cable, why? I don't understand. Surely that's not supposed to do that. That's very concerning. Let's see if the other one does it. It does. It also does it. Okay, that's kind of put me at ease. So either they're both broken or that's just the way it's designed. But aside from that, you've got a little kind of tesseract thing in the top. I don't know if this is just illumination or if there's a tweeter behind it. And I'm also sure they put a lot of effort into ensuring that this triangle doesn't acoustically interfere with that driver, because that's just the kind of attention to detail that you'll put into a $3 product. Now, the headset is the same brand as the mouse. It's Mctenthiddy, so they have diversified into audio as well. Oh, there are actually some specs on the side of the box for these. Oh, they're full range. Wow. Whoa, these are really wild, and they also do that weird cable thing. Yeah, this is actually USB-C, so you plug it straight into your PC. That's a little bit concerning though, because if you're buying $3 headphones, there's a chance your system doesn't have USB-C. So this is actually somewhere I think that it doesn't make sense to have this connector, which is pretty funny. But other than that, these are the most shocking build quality that I have seen on a thing in a very long time. The outside makes Amazon Basics plastic feel high quality, and then the inside is, I don't even know what that is. Ooh. I'm always surprised to what extent all on-ear headphones feel exactly the same, be it this $3 pair, or the much more expensive Amazon Basics pair that I looked at not too long ago. I also got a webcam because I was real curious to see what $3 video quality looks like. I recognize this one, 30 frames per second, which is fine. The human eye can't see above 3, so you don't need more than that. We've got a 60 degree field of view, I'm assuming. But the specs get more terrifying when you get to the side, because on here it says that it records in 640 by 480 quality, which is very, very low resolution. But never mind, it's got CMOS in it, so it's gonna be good. Very professionally crumpled in bit of manual. It's so cute and tiny. Oh, look at it. Its cable also does that weird thing where it's got a little bit of give to it. Kind of, oh, well, okay, you can rotate it. According to the box, you can rotate it in 360 degrees. Oh, it's got very limited pitch. And then it's got like this hair clip that you use to attach it to your PC. But another thing that I'm curious about is it manual focus? It kind of looks like it may be, but on the front of the lens, you get some more information about the camera. Apparently, it's got 4 millimeters of f-stop. That's an interesting way to measure it. And 10 times optical zoom. Whoa, there is no way that's true, but we'll test that a bit later. Again, we get a nice manual, which tells you what the function buttons do and how to plug a USB cable in. That's very useful. Here is our white keyboard, which has a gray cable for some reason. Now, what's really cool about the white keyboard is that it seems like this whole backplate is RGB. There was a black version of this keyboard, but it didn't have that just insane RGB in it. The keycaps are a nice size. You know, they're not that very low profile that you often get on cheaper keyboards. Even for a membrane keyboard, that feels pretty butt cheeks, but it's usable. This may be fine. This may be a usable keyboard. Although it does that. And the final thing was by far the cheapest, and it's this little cat plushie, and it cost just over a dollar, and the whole point of this is to use as a palm rest while using your mouse. So that's pretty nice. You can just kind of lean your wrist on a cat while gaming. A cat that's had a severely savaged tail. Whoa, that cable's short. I need an extension. It is such false advertising. I was expecting the whole undercarriage of it to glow, not that it just reflects the RGB on it a bit better because it's a white surface. But as is always the case, I immediately ran into a problem. The mouse doesn't work. But once I spent enough time randomly flailing it around, yeah, it changed its mind. Oh, there it is. Okay, it does work now. Ooh, it is so tiny and feels really... That's weird. Now again, as I predicted, the inline volume wheel of the speakers is nowhere near to your hands. So you kind of gotta... It also gives you no indication of what the volume is doing. Like, is this full volume or have I muted it? But after a bunch of blindly patting around like the world's most inept lover, yeah, I eventually got it going.
I feel like the best way I can describe them is aggressive. Oh, they lobotomize you every time you click on a menu thing. Ooh,
they're not nearly as comically terrible as I was expecting. I mean, don't get me wrong, they sound really bad, but they just sound like bad computer speakers, you know? They don't step it up in terribleness, unfortunately. But let's give the headset a try. These are shockingly uncomfortable. It feels like having your head in a vice with very little pressure, but it kind of exerts it in very specific spots on your ear. The mouse is very slow to respond. It feels so heavy. Ooh, it does that cheap headset thing where it emphasizes the wrong sounds. So
certain things are really loud, but other things are very quiet. And it's like it just randomly decides which to emphasize. So I really feel like I can't trust the sound at all. Now, in terms of the mouse pad, it's a little bit uncomfortable to use because it's quite a rough texture. So this is the kind of thing that's gonna callus your palms because of the rubbing. Oh, I almost forgot my solution to that problem, which is the little cat. There we go, that's fixed the problem. Although it has created another problem, because the mouse is so low profile and the cat so fat, it lifts my hand even further off the mouse, so I have to kind of curl my wrist around to get to it. That's not very nice. It also takes up a lot of space on the already small mouse pad, so it feels like you're trying to weave your mouse through the Suez Canal. The cat might work for browsing the internet, but for gaming, it really locks your hand in place. This is not a big enough range of movement. But what is interesting about the headphones is I'd say that they're about on par with the Amazon Basics ones in terms of terribleness. Oh, there's someone here. Terrified gunfire into the woods. Oh, yeah. that was terrifying. So after that very brief, terrifying experience, my initial impressions are are not great. My wrist already hurts. The combination of this little teddy with this mouse is a complete disaster ergonomically. Another problem I discovered with the mouse while playing some Counter-Strike was that its sensors tracking is terrible. When you try and smoothly look around, the camera movement is extremely jittery, like your body movement works with gears or something. The keyboard was fine. It is very disappointing that the whole bottom doesn't light up. I very much was expecting that. A genuine issue though is that the keys are quite sticky, and sometimes when you were ASDing around, it would stick in a specific direction. But this only happened a couple times while I was using it, so I guess it's not the end of the world. In terms of the headset, it's also not good at all. It's really difficult to distinguish where things are happening with it. However, for music, the headphones weren't that bad. Now, of course, they had a whole bunch of issues, like the bass was overblown and there was no detail in that region, and generally the sound was quite muddy, but it's better than a lot of budget headsets I interact with. Oh, and the cable is way too short, and we'll test the microphone in a second. Now, when it comes to the speakers, at low volumes, they're okay, but the moment that you turn them up above a whisper, the massively over-accentuated treble really hurts your ears. I mean, it took like 3 minutes of using them before my ears started aching. Whoa. What? Okay, but I'm pretty sure that it's not in focus. I think it's got quite narrow depth of field. Oh, there we go. I think it's got quite narrow depth of field because it takes really long to get to focus.
Although in practice, once it's in focus, everything's in focus, which is convenient.
It almost looks like found footage, to be honest. It's not quite as terrible as I was expecting, which I feel like has been the case for at least a couple of the things we've interacted with. But yeah, that's what it looks like. Is it using its microphone now? It probably is. It probably is. Feels better than like a lot of laptop webcams, not in terms of total fidelity, but just in terms of pleasingness of the image. I don't know. I am kind of pleasantly surprised by that. This is the kind of thing that you can use to make like 70s VHS looking footage, you know?
I think we're recording using this microphone. So I'm curious to see if we can get, I guess, the worst streaming setup ever with the combination of this webcam and this microphone. But again, there's something weirdly pleasing about this.
Now, the microphone is terrible, yeah, but it sounds like camcorder microphone, you know? Like, it's got a real found footage vibe to it.
Like, I could easily remake the Blair Witch Project with the combination of this microphone and that microphone. And gaming in the dark really sold that dirty VHS vibe. Which brings me to the end of my look at the cheapest electronics I've ever seen. And honestly, just the fact that they didn't spontaneously combust the moment I took them out of their boxes is in itself a miracle of modern manufacturing. I mean, you shouldn't buy any of this crap, but it's still wild. And with that, thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel and watch another video. Suggestion will pop up in a second. And until 2 seconds from now, bye-bye.